All right, everyone, next progression away from the inchworm, kind of similar idea, but now I'm holding the inverted position. I don't come out into a plank position. This one's called the bear walk, because I guess I really like bears. Or the friends that I steal these exercises from really like bears. Now, feet down like this, starts just like an inchworm. Hands are flat. Again, you see, we're conserving a lot of things. I've never talked to a camera upside down, I don't think. We're conserving a lot of things so that they're easy to remember, easy to perform, because I need you to perform the details well. Now I gotta stop talking, exhale, tuck my hips, and I got a nice tuck position. You might not be this inclined if you're not as flexible as me. I'm pretty flexible. You might have to be out here, and then your hamstrings can tolerate it. That's totally fine. Okay, it's most important. What's most important is your midsection area, your abdominal area, making sure that you have those abdominal muscles supporting you. I'm talking right into this mic. Okay, hopefully it's not too loud for you guys. So we're going to hold this position, and we're actually going to take ipsilateral steps. So same side foot and arm. So I get a little stretch. I try to put this right heel, the stepping heel, down on the ground, and I try to stretch out this side of my back and my side. And then I take another step. Ooh, that stretch is intense.
And I can cycle through that. You don't have to pause for as long as I did. I just do that so that you can see the positions. I generally give this one set of 20 steps, but if you're using it as, you know, more of a training tool for handstand preparation, maybe we do 3 sets instead to get a little bit more training volume. Hope that helps. This is a great way, again, to get yourself inverted, to load your shoulders more, and to coordinate your ab muscles with the spinal position, the rib cage position, so that you can start to train your strength, but keep your mobility available to you.